Once again, back is the incredible.
Got no time to waste, I'm starting the song right here. A minute 17, really ain't long to spit. So I'ma keep the flow, listen right up, it's clear.
What's going on, guys? So I got another video for y'all. This is a much requested video that I think I'm going to turn into a series if it does well. It's going to be about just proper technique, doing your exercises properly, because a lot of times people don't, they skip that step, you know what I mean? Like, they skip that step and they don't really see how that can really help you when you're working out. Because if you don't do the exercises correctly, what benefit are you getting? What's going to happen is you're going to make those newbie gains, and then you're going to stop, because anybody that goes from moving more, well, their body will change. Okay, if you're very sedentary and then you start moving around, of course you're going to change. But what you need to remember is, if you don't have proper technique, that's not going to matter. So today's video is going to be on proper squat technique. I'm going to show you in the video some good things, some bad things, and also I'm going to put some steps on there so that you can kind of change your form and hit your checklist every time you squat. Now, if you guys like this video, I can do more of them. I can do them on deadlifts, sumo deadlifts, things like that, bench press, just to kind of help you. Now remember, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a professional, I don't know anything. But what I do know is what not to do. So that's what I'm going to tell you about today, is the do's and don'ts of squatting. Now, I'm going to put some videos up here of me squatting, and that way you can kind of see do's and don'ts and things going on with my squat technique, and then I'm going to list it up there. So here we go. So what you got to remember when you're squatting is, there's like five simple rules to squatting, okay? And number one is, you want to have proper form, okay? You want to stand. I like to stand with my feet just a little bit wider than my hips and my toes facing forward as much as possible. You want to get them out too far and you want to get them in too far. So you want to make sure that they're about a little bit wider than your hips, and you want to make sure they're facing straight forward. Now, the reason you want to dovetail out is because you don't have proper mobility. So you're going to see me doing some dynamic stretches on here. You're going to see me doing different things like that I do. You also want to do like hip abductor exercises. I like to do hip abductor exercises inward and outward. Some people will argue that this doesn't really help, but it really opens up my hips. It warms my hips up so that when I do my dynamic stretching, that helps even more, and then I can squat better. Okay, I went from not being able to go all the way down without hurting myself to be able to go all the way down. And so, I mean, the proof is in the pudding. So you want to get that stance right. Then you want to drive your hips back, okay? You want to bend at your knees and your ankles, pressing your knees slightly open, okay? So you're going to sit with your hips back, bend at your knees, bend at your ankles, okay? That's tip number two. Tip number three is going to be, sit in a squat position while still holding your heels and toes on the ground, chest up and shoulders back. What I like to do is, I like to lock my shoulder blades back, open my chest up, and look forward when I'm squatting. I don't look up and I don't look down. If you look down, that's a good way to fall. You want to just look forward, okay? Just in a normal position, look forward. Concentrate on something and just keep looking forward as you're squatting, okay? And you also want to eventually reach parallel, okay? You want to be able to hit 90 degrees when you're squatting. Now, if you start messing up, let's say you're able to go ass to grass, but you start butt winking. And by butt winking, mean is your butt slopes down, you see it kind of winking at the ground and it comes back up. That means you don't have the proper mobility. What that means is you don't need to go down that far, okay? It's okay to go to 90 degrees and stop, if that's as far as you can go. Go as far as you can go without messing your technique up and stop. Get your mobility better, get your hips more warmed up, and then you'll just get better and better. But don't try to push yourself with bad technique just to lift heavier weight. And you'll see that in some of my squats. You'll see butt wink, you'll see not butt wink, and how I just kind of fix that technique to make it a little bit easier. Now, as far as the fifth step goes, that's going to be combining all of these things, but there's some other things that I wanted to add. One, when you go squat, you need to only take three steps back from the rack, okay? You need to pick the weight up, go back three steps, and stop, okay? If you're not set up after those three steps, you're moving around too much. You don't want to move around too much and already get yourself exhausted before you even set up the squat. So three steps, you're set, okay? Put those feet just out of your hips, lock that back, open your chest up, look forward, bend your knees and ankles, and squat, okay? And you want to make sure that you have proper core control as well. You need to be taking a breath in when you're squatting, holding it, squeezing your abdomen, going down, and then breathing out when you go back up. That way you can push with your feet when you're going back up. That's something to remember there. And all of these things will really help you with your squat. And if you don't believe me, just try. Now you might be saying, this is a lot of stuff to remember. Like when I'm squatting, I need to remember all of these steps every time. Well, yeah, you do. And practice makes perfect. So you're just gonna have to concentrate on those steps every time until you figure it out and it just becomes natural. Eventually you'll be like me and you'll be like people that are a lot better than me that are able to just do it without even thinking. And that's the best way to be. That's the way you want it. And eventually your squat will go up. You'll get better. Now, I will mention some exercises that can help you strengthen the rest of your legs so that you can squat better. One of those is going to be hip thrusts. You want to do hip thrusts in order to get those glutes stronger so you have more explosive power. So make sure you're working hip thrusts in your workouts. You don't have to do it with a bar, you can do it with a machine. If the bar is too much trouble to set up, if there's a bunch of people in the gym, you can get on a leg extension machine like I did here and do your hip thrust that way. So another workout that you can do is any kind of leg curls, okay? You can do sitting leg curls, prone leg curls, or standing leg curls to get your hamstrings stronger. You want to get those hamstrings stronger because along with the glutes, they're going to help you have more explosive power. And that's what it's all about. You want to be able to slam that weight back up when you're coming back up so that you can squat properly and you can get stronger and you squat more. And then you get more muscle and you get even bigger. And this keeps going in a circle until you're this big-legged monster. Okay? That's my goal. But I hope you guys like this video. Let me know in the comments what you think about it. Let me know if you want me to do more videos on other techniques. Like I said, I'm not a professional. All I know is what works and what doesn't work as far as my squat goes. I really appreciate you guys watching. Make sure you're subscribed. See you guys later. Bye.